In this video, we're going to discuss backpropagation. In particular, we'll do a toy example of backpropagation, and we'll discuss the vanishing gradient. So there's a lot of math in this section, and I don't want you to worry about that. All I want you to take away from this section is that backpropagation reduces the number of computations involved in calculating the derivative and the problem with the sigmoid function, i.e. the vanishing gradient. So it turns out the neural networks are functions of another function. So the function a is applied to x, and then the function z is applied to the function a. So to help illustrate the process, we're going to use a set of gears. And we have the gear x, and the gear x rotates at a certain rate. And the gear x affects the gear z, but there's also an intermediate gear, and we'll denote it by a. So it turns out that the rate of z is affected by a and then by x. So that when we take a derivative of a function, it actually takes it into account. So the derivative of z with respect to x is the derivative of x with respect to a multiplied by the derivative of a with respect to z. And we call this the chain rule. So let's take a look at this simple toy example of a neural network with one hidden layer and one output layer. And you want to denote the derivative of the hidden layer and the output layer. So we can perform gradient descent on these two terms. So let's calculate the derivative. We'll have our loss function, and let's just use the squared error in this case. So the derivative of the output layer is the derivative of the loss function, and the loss function is a function of the sigmoid function. So we'll have to take a derivative of the sigmoid function with respect to the linear part of the output layer. And then we'll take the derivative of our parameter with respect to the output layer. Things get a little more complicated when we want to calculate the derivative of the parameter in the hidden layer. So let's do that. So the derivative of, with respect to this parameter for the loss function, is the derivative of the loss with respect to the output, which is a function of the sigmoid function. And the sigmoid function is a function of the first linear layer. And then the linear part of the output layer is a function of the first activation. So we have to derive that with respect to the activation. Then we have the initial sigmoid function, which produces the activation. And just a note, it looks something like that. And then we have the final parameter. So that looks pretty complicated. So what backpropagation does is it uses the derivative of the first parameter in the output layer to help us calculate the parameter in the next layer. And that's all it is. So here's the two equations. And we're not interested in the actual equations. We're just trying to understand the concept. So we'll color them out accordingly. And as you can see, these two blue terms are present in the output layer and in the hidden layer. So let's just replace the two blue terms with this red term. And let's see what happens to the parameter in the hidden layer. As you can see, we can replace the two blue terms with this red term, and we get a computational savings. So let's see what happens when we have a deeper network, and we'll use our toy example again. We'll have one neuron per layer. So the derivative of the output layer looks something like this. So the derivative of the layer preceding that layer looks something like this. And the derivative of the layer preceding that looks like that. And then the derivative of the first hidden layer looks like something like that. So as you can see, we have these two blue terms over here, which represent the derivatives. And we're going to replace those two blue terms with this light blue term. So then when we calculate this term over here, we simply replace these two blue terms with this term. And what we'll do is we'll replace these two yellow terms with this ugly maroon color term. Now for this layer, we'll repeat the same process, and we'll replace the blue terms with the term we calculated over here, the two yellow terms with this term, and we'll replace these two green terms with the lighter green term. So when we get to our final layer, we'll use all the terms we calculated before, and then we'll also save these two terms over here for the next layer. So that's all backpropagation really does. And as you can see from the final layer, we reduced the amount of computations required because we simply reused the terms we calculated before. So it turns out a neural network has multiple inputs, and the chain rule also applies, but it gets a lot more complicated. So again, we're not concerned with the actual math, we're just concerned of the concept, what's going on. So let's replace these terms with colors. So let's say we're going to calculate the derivative of the lth parameter with respect to the layer above it. And we get all these terms. Similar for the next neuron, we do the same thing. And we repeat this process for the lth neuron. So instead of layer L, let's say we're on layer L minus 1. And the derivative looks like that. And we can use the same reasoning. And instead of calculating all those terms independently, we can use the terms from the previous calculation, and we can greatly reduce the amount of computation. So we're also going to talk about the vanishing gradient. So let's say we're on the first hidden layer of a neural network. So it turns out if you look at the derivative of the sigmoid activation function, it looks like that. So what happens is we might get a bunch of very small terms. And what happens is the gradient with respect to these terms at the beginning of the network will become very close to zero. Because we're multiplying a small number times another small number. Or if any of these terms are zero, the gradient will equal zero. And what happens when the gradient equals zero to our update equation? Nothing happens. So this is the vanishing gradient. And there's been a lot of ways to solve it. And we're only going to focus on a few. So that's it. And don't worry about the math for this section. Just try to understand the basic concept.